TJP, classic rock in a jazz format.
No doubt about it, she looks so fine. She's the best girl that I ever had. Sometimes she's gonna make me feel so bad. Nah, 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 nah.
So our new album is titled Peace and Love, and the concept came about just thinking about what to do for our next album and seeing what was happening in the world around us at the time of making the album. And so we began to gather all the music we could that dealt with peace and love.
It just came to me, said, you know, it'd be a good idea. And it's a topic that was prevalent, you know, throughout society, because it's such a perfect time to be talking about peace and love. And we tried to capitalize off of things that were important to us growing up in the 70s, and seemed like a lot of those same topics and conversations were still in play today. So it was the right thing to do for the times.
Well, the album Peace and Love came about because of all the stuff that's going on in the country, and you know, during the election in particular, and well, you know, the shootings and everything. So we thought we needed to get the message out.
It's, you know, the whole thing kind of touches on that time about America, and about some of the things that were happening then, they're still happening now.
Laughing on the bus, playing games with faces. She said the man in the gabardine suit was a spy. Oh, and I said, be careful, his bow tie is real.
What we're doing with the tunes, with our tunes from the 60s and 70s, is nothing different than what jazz musicians did in the 30s, 40s, and 50s with standards from the Great American Songbook.
So all that stuff interested me, and I began taking these rock tunes, Led Zeppelin, Iron Butterfly, Aerosmith, the music that really moved me as a teenager, and began to work on them exactly how somebody would take a jazz standard back in the day or something from a Broadway show.
You know, I don't want to write things just to have something be hip or cool. I'm trying to find that thread that kind of rings with me. So many times I'm working on something and it's, you know, I have to recognize that it just doesn't need this thing that I'm trying to force in there. It needs the air, you know? So I've equated this before to the thing about sculptors saying that they see what it is they're going for, it's just they're removing the clay. They already see what they're going for.
This group, I think what's happening now is our name and our music is getting out. There's more and more people knowing about us, and I think we're having more opportunities to travel and play.
It's a great luxury for me to be able to play outside the country. It's a luxury to play anywhere, and of course in America, but to be able to see some of the world is just so wonderful. I'm glad that music allows me to do that and allows me to communicate to different people in different parts of the world. It's really great. I love it, I love it, I love it.
Across the wide Missouri.
With TJP performing our rock tunes, our tunes, you know, classic rock tunes from the 60s and 70s, seems to strike more of a chord with our audiences.
So when we get out there and play In a God of the Vida or play Walk This Way, and to see the people's faces when we begin playing these songs, it's really cool because our job is to move people. But when I play this music, I really get something out of it, you know, and I really get something from the audience that really kind of turns me on.
Sound.